morning, everyone. Everyone, please to rise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
In the waters of baptism, Sarah died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him eternal glory. On the day of her baptism, Sarah put on Christ. On the day of Christ's coming, may she be clothed in glory.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The brothers and sisters devoted themselves to the teachings of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of the bread and the prayers. Awe came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's need. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals in exultation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in the psalm refrain found in the gathering hymnal number 691.
You are the shelter of the Lord. Oh, abide in
reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, saw a new heaven and a new earth. The former heaven and the former earth had passed away, and the sea was no more. I also saw the holy city, a new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Behold, God's dwelling is with the human race. He will dwell with them, and they will be his people. And God himself will always be with them as their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there shall be no more death or mourning, wailing or pain, for the old order has passed away." The one who sat on the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give a gift from the spring of life-giving water. The victor will inherit these gifts, and I shall be his God, and he will be my son." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please, Mom. Sarah is enjoying in heaven that rejoices in the great kingdom. kingdom was promised to us by Jesus on the cross when he said, "You will be with me in paradise." Sarah understands that very well in its totality. But it wasn't her death that she came to know about this. She led her life in this. She led her life in Christ. The readings that we shared, the Acts of the Apostles, talking about the breaking of the bread, they knew Jesus, talking about going forward in the ways of Christ, proclaiming his resurrection, that there's a suffering, but there's a great ending to that suffering, which brings great joy. Sarah lived this, but not just in her faith, in everything that she did. For you and I both know the many great joys she had in her life, the love she had in her life, her family, first and foremost, Gary, family, extended family, good friends. They were always on her mind, in her heart, along with her Savior, Lord Jesus Christ. I think many of you, if not all of you, know she was quite involved with education in Thornton School District for sure, but also here at our St. Joseph's School. She loved not just her family, but those who were like her family, the young ones. She took care of her community, watching out for anything that might not be really healthy for the community in Crime Watch. Why? Because she cared. And you know some of the finer things. She did enjoy crafting. She enjoyed being parts of the church, especially the Catholic Daughters of America, or taking part in the council. When you're in a council, you know that there are many different opinions. Sarah would support the opinion, but like the gospel we shared, blessed are the peacemakers. They will be called the children of God. Was she not the peacemaker? Most definitely. Coming together on sides, doing things for the good of all people, always putting herself out. A very sweet woman, a very gentle woman, a very strong woman in her faith. The readings that we share is just one cross-section of this great lady. But all of the things that she did in her life pointed again to love, peace, and joy, her family, and the extended family of the people in the kingdom of God. She lived this life, and hopefully she taught us to live that life. We bear witness, not just by acts of the apostles or we as disciples, but we bear witness to this because we do look forward to that new and heavenly Jerusalem. Again, Sarah understands that because she's here. She's with our Lord Jesus, who is taking care of her. But she lived this life, always expecting and praying for that new life in God. And indeed, she has that. When the Lord called her home from her sickness, her ailments, from everything that she was going through, not just one hand, I truly believe both hands. Well done, Sarah. Come live with me forever in heaven. And you know what? I would also be truthful in my spiritual thoughts. Well done, live with me in heaven, and don't worry about your family on earth, as you have taken care of them, as you have loved them, as they have loved you. I will watch over them in a very special way, because that's who she was. That's what she is. So the scripture is very important, but the life that she lived was also important, because her ways pointed to Christ, pointed to scripture. She might be almost like Jesus in the living word, for she lived her life that way. So many times in a funeral, I talk about photographs, pictures, I must say, at least every funeral or every other one. These things that we have, they're in our hearts and our souls. We see these images and we hold fast to them. For these images, we will share again in that new and heavenly Jerusalem. I ask you a question and put you to a challenge. Is there something that Sarah did for you? Did she talk with you in a special way? Did she share something with you or for you? I would say yes, all of us in some way. Even me, the new boy on the block. What a great way to live. And now we are strong because of her. And maybe because of her, we go out leading a stronger life. But in closing, the gospel passage that we share these Beatitudes. Jesus started his public ministry. He began his life in his Father with these Beatitudes. Sarah walked, talked, lived them. A peacemaker, a woman looking for righteousness, someone who was pure of heart, someone who didn't care about persecution. She might have had her heart hurt somewhere, but she kept moving forward. All of these things that Jesus started his ministry with, Sarah lived, but now she begins in a new life in heaven. As Christ started a new world here, he has a new heaven named Jerusalem. Sarah shares in this. Let us give thanks to God that we have had such a great woman in our lifetime. Let us give thanks to God that he let his only begotten Son die so that our death might have meaning. The last thing that I share on a personal note, I want to recognize and say how holy, how blessed you are. Family, you took very good care of her. This family, 2 funerals a week, and the love that they gave their loved ones should be an inspiration to us all. May God bless you for your love that you returned to her that she gave to you. That's huge in your faith life. And God sees this, and Sarah now rejoices in it in the kingdom of heaven. Let us all take our cue from the Master Jesus Christ and a living cue from Sarah to do the best that we can for other people. It's in doing others that we gain for ourselves. A little bit here in totality in the kingdom of heaven. Please rise. Dear family and friends, Jesus Christ is risen from the dead. He sits at the right hand of the Father, where he prays and intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voices of those who trust in the Lord Jesus, we join our prayers to his. Our response is, hear our prayer after each. In baptism, Sarah received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead her over the waters of death. Lord, in your mercy. Our sister was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome her into the halls of the heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy. Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. Lord, in your mercy. Those who trust in the Lord will sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. Lord, in your mercy. The family and friends of Sarah seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and death that come from grief. Lord, in your mercy. We are assembled here in faith and in confidence to pray for our sister. Strengthen our hope so that we may live in the expectation of your Son's final coming. Lord, in your mercy. And now, in the quiet of your heart, and your own prayers for Sarah. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, giver of peace and healer of souls, listen to the prayers of the Redeemer, Jesus Christ, and the voices of your people whose lives were purchased by his blood. Forgive the sins of all who sleep in Christ and grant them a place. place in your heavenly kingdom. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
The hymn for preparation of the gifts is found in the gathered hymnal, number 828.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs and angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim you.
Oh,
was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of
He peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy. resurrection of Jesus Christ, which we celebrate in this Holy Eucharist, bring our sister Sarah the peace of your eternal home. Through Christ our Lord. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Sarah, and now we come to the last of our life. There is sadness and parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall joyfully see Sarah again and enjoy her love and her friendship. Although we will disperse in sadness and sorrow, the love and mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his heavenly kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
The response for the song of farewell may be found in the Gather Hymnal, number 163.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our sister Sarah in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, she will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Sarah within this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Jesus. Merciful Lord, turn toward us now. Listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our sister forever. Through Christ our Lord. In peace, let us take our sister to her place of rest.
The recession begins in the gate.